Chancellor for inviting me to chair the third session entitled Youth Converting Electoral Democracy into Participatory Democracy through RPI, Right to Information, the most important question. To start off with, the Right to Information. The RPI Act has been passed all over India since 2005 and in Goa since 1999. This act has been able to make RPI a fundamental right granted in a democratic nation such as ours. This sort of a right should be in our power by default. We should be having the authority to question the government that we ourselves have elected. That should go without saying. But passing an act entirely dedicated to this purpose makes sure that they are legally bound to give us the information that we seek, and that's the whole purpose of the RPI Act. But what's happening today is, even though most of us are aware of the Act, we don't know the potential or the power that it actually gives us. As a common man, we are entitled to question any flaws on the part of the government that might be disrupting our day-to-day activities. Using the RPI, we can demand to know why the roads to our schools or colleges aren't fixed, or why are there constant electrical shutdowns in our area. By utilizing the RPI to make such demands, we are shifting the government's attention to such faults so that they are forced to reprimand them. We are also suggesting ideas to improve our own governance. We are speaking about collaborative governance, where our collective wisdom is employed to improve democracy. Of course, we already have a few instances where people have stood up to the government with the help of this RPI Act. One such example is the Adarsh Society scam, which led to the resignation of the Maharashtra CM, that is Ashok Chavan. However, in spite of such successes, the today's average common man is accustomed to tolerating many inconveniences that are caused to them due to failures on the part of the government. He's hence hesitant to voice himself, and that's where the role of us youth comes into play. Today's youth are already known to be rebellious and inquisitive and bold enough to voice themselves, and we could hence be the perfect users of the RPI Act. My point being, our role doesn't have to stop with voting. We could do so much more than that. The right, like the RPI, we have a weapon much more powerful than what we think, right at our disposal. If we as a part of India's youth could be responsible for making the last general election with youth success as the first session enlightened us about, then why not start making a difference with the RPI Act? India already is a young nation, we all know that. If we could together exploit the RPI in a positive way, into creating a voice so powerful that could actually challenge the government and remind them that they are there because of us, a voice that could be sounded through the RPI, they imagine the kind of difference it would make. Concluding with which, this hence isn't just an electoral democracy where our role stops after election, stops after voting. No, it's a participatory democracy, an open source governance where our input can always be fed by utilizing our rights to information. I now open the floor to our student panel who will voice their opinions about the topic today. We hope to garner a holistic understanding of this landmark act to empower the citizens of India. I request Mr. S. Sudaru of V.M. Sardarpur College of Law in Drama, Goa, to share a few thoughts.
Youth converting electoral democracy into participatory through RTI, the most important weapon. With great power comes great responsibility. I'm sure most of us present here must have surely heard about this famous phrase. Keeping this phrase in mind, we need to ask an important question. Who is the most powerful in our country? Many of us might say it's we the people, but that's not true. In reality and practically, it's the government who is the most powerful. This is the reason why it needs to be the most responsible of all. The youth in India have taken this task of converting our government to a responsible entity through RTI, that's Right Information, thus participating in a democracy, which wasn't the case earlier. Earlier, the job of the youth was over after casting their votes and electing their representatives. The rest was left to the representatives to do whatever they like, which led to a great amount of corruption and inefficiency. But since 2005, the RTI Act has built an impressive trajectory. In an era of global youth rebellion, it has opened up space for India's youth to demand their right to know. They demand a new way to run the country. But there is no rock tear gas fight in the state. They prefer to work within the rule of law, engage in communities, and demand change, not just in their personal lives, but for good governance and against corruption in the wider society. There are several instances to prove how the youth of India have taken RTI as a weapon to unearth mass corruption and inefficiency. One such example is that of Aishwarya Parashar, aged 12 years. She was known to ask the right questions. One day, while studying a chapter on Mahatma Gandhi, she asked a question which no one could answer. Who gave him the title, Father of the Nation? As no one could answer this question, she decided to tap resilient sources, including the Prime Minister, through the RTI Act on February 13, 2012. Although her application was written on a school notebook paper in a childish writing, it could not be dismissed by the nation's top office. It was a flawless application, as legally binding and enforceable as any. As the letter changed hands from the Prime Minister's office, the Home Ministry, and the National Archives, a national secret was leaked out. Although mentioned in several textbooks, Gandhi was never officially conferred the honorific title of Father of the Nation. Aishwarya Parashar has been using the RTI Act since the age of 7 and is the youngest face among the growing brigade of information warriors. Another example is that of Bhadresh Panjab, 18 years old from Gujarat, who took up RTI for a good cause for his village. Thanks to him, the Gujarat government passed an order making it mandatory for all FairPrice shops in the state to disclose details of all rations received and stocked in stores. This happened because he observed that the villagers, the two FairPrice shops in his village, refused rations to the villagers. He filed RTI after RTI in order that this judgment was passed. Like this, there are several other youngsters who use the RTI daily for a good cause. Also, in schools, RTI clubs have begun. Pages are there on Facebook, such as the Indian Youth RTI Club, which help the youth how to write an application and also informs them to come up with issues on which RTI needs to be filed. Every young RTI activist gets all charged up and thinks of himself as an RTI activist. They are fearless and patient. They want to fight against the system in order that truth and justice prevail. But the road for young RTI activists is not easy. Filing an RTI is often complicated, and if you don't write properly, you need to file it all over again. Often they are expelled from schools and colleges. They are confronted by angry neighbors and teachers and schools, and often pressurized by parents. Yet they still pick up the administrative dirt. For them, the charm of RTI far outstrips its dangers. I'd like to ask a question. How many of you all here know how to file an RTI application? Hardly few. Even myself, I did not know how to file an RTI application a few days ago. We ones are known to be susegar, but this shouldn't be for each and everything. We need to be serious and start waking up and do something for our country. Corruption is the most important issue, but RTI is the most important weapon in order so that corruption eradicates. We youth need to start participating and thus make a democracy a real democracy. Thank you.
Thank you. Next is Kenan Logi, sir, from St. Xavier College, Mapsa, Goa. My topic for this session is youth converting electoral democracy into participatory democracy through RTI, the most important weapon. RTI, that is Right to Information, is an app that was introduced to us in the year 2005. It is the app that provides for setting out the practical design of right to information for citizens. RTI is a key enabler of good governance and is a tool to ensure participation of public in governance, eliminate corruption, and of course to empower the people. It gives the citizens the right to seek information and makes it binding on officials to store and make the information easily available to the public, with the exception only when withholding the information in public interest. Now, how far is a country democratic? Democracy is all about good
governance, transparency and responsibility. But we having no chance to question our government, probably we fail somewhere around to be a participatory democracy. As for the common understanding of people, what they do is they cast their vote against a random candidate and feel that their work is over. But there is a lot more by which they can actually contribute and make democracy participatory. RDI has been one of the most potent mechanisms through which citizenry have become inclusive partners in democratic setup. With implementation of RDI, people have empowered to explore information and interactively use it in the process of not only bringing about changes in governance but also rightfully pointing out the shortcomings of governance mechanisms, consequently resulting in better administration of government. RDI has transformed various sectors in government functioning. In terms of elections, people can now get information about the candidate contesting for elections. RDI gives people an insight in knowing the background of the contestant for political offices at different levels. Now that information can be like that of their health, wealth and also the criminal background, which in turn helps and enlighten people in making a better and a wiser choice. In terms of administration, with the help of RDI, people have now become vigilant citizens, constantly following up with the government related administration affairs. Administration has today become receptive. Administration are today on guard, realizing the fact that they have to be responsive to the public needs and demand. Media. Media has also benefited from the enactments of legislation like RDI. It has effectively used the same in bringing before the people information in a democratic setup. People are the ultimate beneficiaries, indeed, as they can now understand and take decisions in better and judicious manner with the loads of information that is being flooded by media. Third is time-bound mechanism. Today, delivery of services of administration in a democracy have become a time-bound affair. As participants in democracy, people are today entitled and rightfully are dispensed with services because it has become a compulsion for government administrators to follow in line with the implementation of RDI. In a democracy, people are the masters and government exists to serve them. People have a right to know how they are governed. Ours is a representative democracy. We elect our representatives who in turn rule us. We therefore should have a correct knowledge about our representatives. Availability of information enhances people's participation by providing them an opportunity to know and act accordingly. It is said today that with such enlightened citizenry and active citizens, the democratic process has become vibrant, meaningful, where people have come of age and have become partners in governance. It is no more a one-way process as it used to be before. In fact, because of RDI, the process has become more of consultative, reciprocative and healthy bonding, which is taking place between people on one hand and the authorities of governance on the other. So that's how that's the point that our country is heading towards a healthy participatory democracy.
Next is Khushbu Shah from the Government College of Arts, Science and Commerce, who gives us a view on the topic.
Good afternoon, everyone. RDI is the right to information. It is said that information is the oxygen of democracy. If people do not know what is happening in the society, if the actions of those who rule they are hidden, then they cannot take a meaningful part in the affairs of the society. Goa was a fun-loving state after the liberation, when people lived without fear and they felt safe. But in few years, things really changed in a very different manner. Situations turned bad has in many mega projects, building complex came up, major problems like poverty, unemployment problems, etc. rised. But now, the RDI is like broad cavity of our state, as it helps us to know and to get information about the laws in our society. Under the Act of RDI on Quality politician, businessman, or a company owner cannot appoint their kin and team for any job. If they do so, then through transparency, the candidates is checked on and are taken into action, or they have to pay fine. In the way the RTI helps a lot for today's generation to get this to get their rights, therefore RTI is the most potent weapon. Thank you.
Thank you, Kushbu. Next is Pranav Kapurkar from G.R. Kali College of Law.
Good afternoon, to one and all. As you all know that our topic has some four major focal points, that is electoral democracy, participatory democracy, the role of the youth, and party. It is said that a democracy is a government for the people, of the people, by the people. We can get, we are ensured by the democratic type of government, but what about a good governance? If the representatives of the people are not governing it properly, entire democracy fails. In many democratic countries like ours, we have been experiencing an unfortunate reality that the government is elected by the people, but once it is elected, the representatives fails to do the justice. India is the only country in the world having the millions and millions of populations of the youth, and the youth should participate in the policies and the government decisions. It is not only that, from mere participation, the youth have to do something with regards to the implementation of those decisions. How is this possible? The youth should participate in an active politics, that is, in an actual political process, and not just a student unionism. Exercising their right to information is one such method or the medium through which this can happen. The RTI Act of 2005 is basically considered as a legislation which brings about the light of secrecy of administration. It is an efficient means to promote the democratic ideology. Through RTR, the corruption can be checkmated. At the same time, there is a transparency in the administration of the government. The good governance and RTR are basically complementary to each other. The good governance is characterized by political accountability, availability of freedom, the bureaucratic accountability, availability of information, the law-abiding citizens, efficiency, there should be a cooperation between the government and the society. And as such, the right to information is a natural corollary of good governance. The enactment of RTI Act 2005 introduced an open and a transparent government and gave every citizen the right to seek information, to receive the information, and participate in the decision making of the government. This act also says that the democracy required an informed citizenry and also the transparency of government, which are very much important in order to build a strong democracy. If we see the previous trend for the enactment, the people is to abide by the rules, laws, regulations, and the government was acting as a machinery to control. But after the enactment of 2005, there has been a tremendous change with this regard. Now the government is also has to abide by the rules, laws and regulations, and people is got the entire controlling power. Thus, this act is regarded as a milestone in the history of social legislation to share the information to the citizens regarding the working of the government and to make them more transparent, as a result of which the corruption can be checkmated to a greater extent. The people need to see the RTI as a pathway to change, and there is a need to work collectively in order to use this RTI laws. There is a need of awareness and education among the youth with regards to the RTI provision so that they can make use of it and at the same time can fight against the injustice that is happening to them. The youth are aware about their right in order to make the participate in the various political functions with a view of developing a strong local self-government. Research also shows that the development can be successful when the youth participate in any project to a direct involvement in a key decision which affects the most of the people today. The democratic function at a national level will become more effective if there is a democracy right from the panchayat to the parliament. In Hindi that we say that from Delhi to Delhi. If we consider it in the bigger sense, democracy should start from the panchayat to the parliament. That is from every institution, right from the family to the educational institution. Mahatma Gandhi rightly said that, "I don't believe in a democracy which counts the heads, and not the brains. Today's youth has a right thinking, a brain. Also, Mahatma Gandhi has commented that I don't believe in a democracy which makes the 50 plus 1 equals to 100. That is a plain mathematical calculation. Mere one majority, that is mere 51, gives the entire power to one party, which leads to the corruption. To have an effective check on this, RTI plays a very important role. And in order to convert this participatory democracy, the RTI is must, and the participation of the youth has no other option. With this, I would like to conclude by saying, by thanking AC Mascarenhas, Chelsea Mascarenhas, Elroy Ribeiro, and also the Nessa D'Souza for helping me in preparing this paper. Thank you and have a
great day. Next is Ramanand Gaonkar from Government College of Arts, Science and Commerce, Sakhalin.
First of all, good afternoon, one and all. Recently in India, 2014, general election has took place, in which more than 70% people have voted. And in this election, our youth had played an important role in electing their leaders. The famous dictator Victor said, "The alone who owns the youth gains the future," and it almost a true. Because today youth are playing major role in development and shaping of our country's economic and education way. These 2014 general elections were mainly focused on youth participation. In India, more than 50% population is young, and they have played a crucial role in 2014 Lok Sabha election. Around 378 million voters were between the age of 18 and 35. It was said that 90,000 of these voters were the age of 18 to 22, and they were the time voters and have their own aspirations from the political position aiming to form the new government. These young voters want a corruption-free society, social benefits, clean and hygienic food, water, food, good roads and transport facilities, more investment, best education, good salary, job security, and above all, more jobs for educated people. They expected that the next government will fulfill the expectation, and they had fed up with the empty assurances. And they had said that we are for change. Youth also said that in 2014 elections, they want to see the new faces in India. Today, youth in any society played a very important role, and today they are more aware than before 2 years they were back. Today, because of high education, every younger knows to fight for their freedom, rights, etc. Due to social media and social networking sites, this youngster ideas has scattered all over the country, and during the 2014 Lok Sabha election, and social media and social networking sites are stronger tool to grab the ideas of youth. They find a platform on social media to express themselves. They are also expressing their dissatisfaction against the incumbent government on social media. The issues like unemployment, slum economy, corruption and lopsided foreign policy had led youth to protest against the government. During the campaign of Lok Sabha election, both Congress leader Rahul Gandhi and BJP leader Narendra Modi were knowing the importance of young voters. So they mainly focused on the youth voters. RTI, the right to information. This was a potent weapon of youth in the Lok Sabha election. The youngsters were asking the questions on ongoing process, development, planning commission, corruption, through which government should provide them with correct information. Youth had their power to transform their own nation, and it will. There were many candidates who were youngsters like Jyotirao Scindia, Sachin Pilot, etc., who got a huge support from the young voters. The responsibility of transformation progress and innovations lies on young shoulders. The youth had casted their vote after the serious thought on the nature and policies of their parties, without a doubt, and they played a major role in electing their leaders.
So, I once again thank all our speakers for giving their valuable views on the topic of the session. I next request our next part to lot of speakers. That will be Reena Sharma from the Institute of Nursing Education, Bangalore. Sameer Amar from Bidpilani, KK Birla Goa Campus, Vadinagar. Shireen Sheikh from Vidya Prabodhini College, Porvodin. Swinburne Fernandez from Rotary College of Commerce and Arts. And Saidi Nayak from the Government College, Coimbatore. First,
Reena
Sharma from the Institute of Nursing Education will give her views on the topic.
Good afternoon to Varun, our guest. It is said that your eyes cannot see what your mind doesn't know. So, it is very important to have thorough knowledge before you judge anything that Indian democracy is considered to be an electoral democracy. It's because people only participate actively with power that they've got only during elections. That is, they cast their votes to elect their particular neta, and then they sit back and be passive observer of what's going on. But this should not happen. The RTI Act of 2005 gives us the right to fight and to get knowledge regarding what is happening in the government. It gives us a chance to know about the government's functioning and question about it. We should utilize it. Only then the Indian democracy will become participatory democracy. There is no limit to what change you can bring about with the help of RTI. Anybody, starting from the anybody working as a peon to a big businessman, anyone can file an RTI. You can check on the net, there is a format to file an RTI. The reply will be given by the PIO, which will be posted at your doorstep. Now it's a big gossip about different people. Like, why she did like that? She's so rude. She doesn't know anything. She's so stupid. We keep on gossiping. We all like gossiping. But we never think like we should go and ask that person whether she really did it. Same thing maybe with the government. Like, if something happened in the government which we think shouldn't have happened, we never make an initiative to just find out what exactly was there. The government might have a significant reason why they did it. But instead we just keep on gossiping and talking about the government. I'll give you all an example. Very now, a third standard student, she, along with the help of her parents, she filed an RTI against the garbage that was being dumped in front of a school. A third standard student can make such a difference. After this application, the garbage dumping area was shifted to some other place. A third standard student can make such a difference, then why are we lacking behind? You all must have seen the movie Nayak, in which it is said that politics is a gutter. Lekin isko saaf karne ke liye koi uttarda nahi hai. So if you all are not taking initiative to clean this mess, to aapko koi hak nahi banta kisi ko kuch panda karne ka, kisi bhi neta ko kuch bolne.
For you to talk on the topic of youth converting electoral democracy into participatory democracy through RTI. Now, as I move on, I will try to clear as many jargons which are present in the theme in the course of my discussion. So, in India, the state has spread its tentacles to virtually every aspect of our social life, and it is a supreme ruling entity of our nation. But the issue of contention is rather how much have we engrossed ourselves into its machinery. Now, the Indian state enfranchises its citizenry with the right to cast their vote and elect their leaders once in every 5 years in a representative parliamentary system of democracy. And this whole system is known as the electoral system of Indian democracy. So this was the first diagram which was present on our topic, that was the electoral democracy. Now, there is another facet of democracy which legitimizes its citizen a greater opportunity for more active political participation rather than a mere once in a 5 year suffrage identity. So this form or this facet of democracy allows us to audit, scrutinize and participate in all or every government process. So this phase of democracy, this very phase of democracy that we are talking about is the participatory democracy, which was the second target in our team. So the important aspect of this form of democracy is that it requires accountability. The word which is fundamental to the occupation of any functioning democracy, and the absence of which renders the democracy completely illegitimate, corrupt and dead. So to bring this transparency and accountability, the most important act to the cause has been the right to information of 2005. Now, I had wished to elucidate a brief emergence of the RTI, but since the time has been curtailed, I would skip it because it helps you understand that RTI was nothing new, but the effectuation of Article 19 of the Constitution, which was endowed upon us by our forefathers more than 60 decades ago. But since we have shorter time, I would just give you one trivia, which is that in India, Goa was the first state in 1997 to introduce a legislation on the subject of RTI. Now, moving on to a very good example which will help us illustrate the role RTI has played in empowering the youth. Now, in this example, there's this guy by the name of Uday. He was a software engineer like us. I mean, we are also engineers, at least I am an engineer. I'm doing my engineering. So, this guy, he used to live in Vasantpur in New Delhi, and he worked in HCL. Now, he used to travel the ring road to opposite of IIT Delhi, and he noticed that the stretch of road of the flyover between IIT Delhi and Panchi flyover, it started to wear off within 10 days of its construction. Now, it's not a very big deal in India, obviously. Many roads start to come up within weeks and fortnights. But this enlightened citizen of our nation, he filed an RTI and he demanded three things. Specifically, he stipulated that he wanted inspection of all files, he wanted to inspect the road, and he wanted to take sample of the material used in the construction of the road. He was given a particular date and time for the whole procedure to take place. But in the meanwhile, he was approached by a concerned junior engineer and several other officials who tried to persuade him not to go through the files, but rather they asked him, why don't you just come and take a look at the road, and if you find any more discrepancy, since we have relayed the road just a few days ago, and if you find any other fallacy, any other discrepancy, we would again make it even better if you wish to, but don't go through the files. So later on it was found that the whole corruption was hidden within the files. The underpayment to the contractor, the use of substandard materials, all of it was hidden within the files. And now, these politicians have these files as their Pandora box. The moment you open it, they are apprehensive. They don't know what will happen to the files that are in the public domain. Because as far as possible, they try to keep it impervious. But as soon as it gets into the public domain, they are not aware whether it might go to CBI or a public interest litigation may be filed or whatsoever may happen of it. So, see, the filing of simple RTI caused many things to automatically fall in place and forced the government machinery to rectify the mistakes. There are many more examples which reiterate the same fact and manifest to us the lethality of such a weapon at our disposal. Now, in my final statement, I would like to discuss the fact that we should use such an accessible potent weapon that we have. Now, many of us in our lives have never fought an RTI in spite of our grievances because we had this chaotic image, a tumultuous image of the RTI process in our mind, or as far as my friends told me. So I would like to say that RTI is a very, very simple process. It just requires you writing an application, get a payment slip, and send it to the public information officer or the assistant public information officer. And by all means, you get your information within 30 days, or you or the official in charge will be charged at rupees 22 per day as fine, or 25,000 if he misinforms you. Now, the onus is on us for using it as responsibly as possible. With this statement, I would like to end my presentation. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sameer. Next is Shireen Sheikh from Vijayapur Bodhi College.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Shireen Sheikh from Vijayapur Bodhi College. My topic is on youth converting electoral democracy into participatory democracy through RTI. Many years post-independence, Indian democracy didn't possess a mechanism that would provide secure access to information under the control of public authorities, and which would promote transparency and accountability in the working of every public authority until the RTI Act was passed in the year 2005. The Indian public didn't have much option in terms of participatory politics. For years, a citizen was only considered as a tool during the elections. Politicians will use the people once every 5 years and then forget about them. People also in turn didn't have much of choice, as all their oral and written complaints had to fall on deaf ears. The general population as well as the youth of our country was disillusioned by this, as can be seen in the late 80s and 90s, where a majority of politicians were well beyond the age of retirement. And the youth with the daily burden of unemployment, inflation, corruption, etc. had given up all hope. At the same time, some people were trying very hard to bring about transparency in the government and bureaucratic mechanisms. The efforts of these activists led to the establishment of national level law. The central government appointed a working group under the H.P. Shaori and assigned it the task of drafting legislation. The Shaori draft was the basis for the Freedom of Information Bill 2000, which eventually became law under the Freedom of Information Act 2002. This act was severely criticized and consequently never came into effective force. A revised version of the draft was passed in an act 2005. After implementation, the RTI received mixed reactions from all quarters. On one hand, when the Aam Aadmi was very happy about the law, political parties and the government offices were not so pleased. They began citing reasons such as restriction of time, work overload, informality replies. But at the same time, the layperson had got a weapon that he might have never read of, and now he was ready to use it to its fullest. The youth are supposedly the driving force behind the highest ever turnout witnessed in the recently concluded Lok Sabha polls. However, they are still languishing in minority when it comes to bank party activities. If a candidate up to 50 years of age can be considered as young in politics, the two main parties in the frame, BJP and Congress, fielded this time 37% and 35% young candidates respectively. However, the newborn Aam Aadmi Party tried to change the trend by reaching about 58% of youth candidates. Interestingly, if the criteria of young candidates changes to 40 years instead of 50, then these parties display a dismal show. By this method, Aam Aadmi Party had about 31% of young candidates, followed by Congress 14% and the BJP by 12% respectively. Knowing now that the BJP has won the 2014 election also tells us about the choice of general populace. The public does not only go by the age criterion but also focuses on the will, fervor, dynamism and interest that the politician exhibit while working for the development of the society rather than feathering one's nest. There are few things which need to be clarified. One, that the youngsters do not mean people who are 20 years old with no experience at all. The youth in this context is meant to refer people with the 30s or early 40s with a good mixture of energy and experience. Two, it is not intended to mean that old people should leave the political scene at rest. What is wanted is that they should be there but for the guidance because they are treasure of unvaluable experience. There are RTI activists ranging from the ages of 19 to 70 years. Many of the RTI applications are found to be filed by the senior citizens. This is sometimes frowned upon as these senior citizens supposedly have a lot of time on their hands. The officials replying to their queries often look down upon them. But one also has to realize that the way that we handle after youth power, so also these people but valid citizens of the country, and we need to go forward as a united force and not segmented into various groups. At the same time, we need to ask ourselves, is getting into active politics the only way to contribute to society, to participate in the democratic process? At last, I will conclude by saying, if in spite of all this, our youth don't take advantage of the provided mechanisms and opportunities and try to blame everything on everyone else, then it will just be a couple of years before we actually turn into a banana republic or suffer from a political and social unrest.
Thank you, Shreem. Next is Swinburne Fernandez from Rosary College of Commerce.
A basketball in my hands is worth about 300 rupees. But a basketball in Michael Jordan's hand is $3 million. It depends in whose hands it is in. A tennis racket in my hand is useless. But a tennis racket in Michael Jordan's hand is Wimbledon championship. It depends in whose hand it is. A cricket bat in my hand is for mere entertainment, but a cricket bat in Sachin Tendulkar's hand carries dreams and hopes of thousands and millions of people. It depends in whose hands in it. But today, I am not an ordinary man. We are not an ordinary people because the most important weapon, the most important tool which can shake the mighty, upset the righteous, and that is the right to information. As I begin, I would like to break my topic into four parts. The first is youth, the conversion, the RTI, and the fourth is the conclusion. Andrew Paderewski, one of the great musicians, was about to showcase his piece, musical piece. Just a few minutes before, a boy walks to the aisle to play the piano. And he starts playing the Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. The people in the audience start laughing. Simple piece he's playing, kona podeta ho. But Andrew Paderewski came to the piano, encouraged him, say, come on, play, start playing, don't quit. On the left he gave the bass, and on the right he added the fillings. And that same simple Twinkle Twinkle Little Star became the masterpiece of that day. We youth are like that. We have the ability, simple beginning, but the experience of the people in power helps us a lot, and that can make a masterpiece. So the youth have passion, they are passionate people. You tell us to do anything for our days, passionate people. We got energy, zeal, all of these things, but we need experience. Not that we lack, but we have not seen many rings and sunshines. We need experience. Second, participation. Our late Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi believed that Panchayat Raj is very important because it includes participation. From the very ground level, it includes everyone's opinion. Today, our Chief Minister, this Minister, that Minister drafts a document. So many oppositions are there. If it was started from Panchayat and everyone is included, why we have to waste so much of money and time opposing it? We can include our own opinion at the ground level. That is what participation is. Tackling it at a ground level so that you don't waste our time and energy. So participation is very included because your opinion counts. Your views, they count. And then when it counts, different minds come together and help it for a better functioning. Third one is RTI. My fellow colleagues have spoken a lot on RTI. What I would like to say is this, RTI is not only concerning government. It starts. Now, you cannot all of us enter politics. Tomorrow we become MLA, no. But we can start wherever we are. In your class, you have energy, you are passionate. Start with interact. There is something going on, not going so well. So you can start. You can say, okay, we'll fight against it. We'll work together. And then you work against it for the betterment of the people. So there you have already started. Don't go to government. Start at the grassroots level. Start from where you are. And then you can perform. So four things together. First is, we are passionate people. We have got a lot of energy. Make use of it. Secondly, we need to include everyone. It is very difficult to work as a team. It is very easy to work single-minded because ideas, it is very easy, okay, I think like that, I work. So it is difficult to get someone's, buy someone's idea, difficult. So include everyone, everyone's view it helps, trust me. And third one is RPI, that is basically ask some people, include, ask, that is very important, that is your right. So do it and trust me, we can all do it and everything connects. Don't think something is happening in pen chain, something is happening there, no. It's like a food chain, we all connected. So anything is happening, if one policy that we all are connected, we all, it matters a lot. So let us work together. I know it is like, you know, we have come for, we may get a...
Number one, contact paper. Electoral democracy is one in which people elect their representatives through voting. But participatory democracy is one in which people actively take part in affairs of the state. They have the right knowledge, ask questions to government and give their suggestions. The law of right to information was implemented on 13 October 2005. Empowered the citizens of India with the right to get information from government. It is the common transparency and accountability in the working of every public authority. In a short tenure of about 8 years, RTI has proved to be a very successful law. People are using RTI to build business scams, fraud, cases about corruption, etc. But there are many limitations restricting the flow of the RTI. RTI can only be used to get information from public authorities. Here, I ask the question. Why only public authorities and not private bodies too? Private education institutions charge very high fees. If someone asks for any information, they deny that saying they don't come under RTI and reject the appeals. The officers are under the watchful eyes of such teachers and therefore sometimes get to give any information. It may deceive the politicians, resulting in removal of them from their post. Sometimes officials clearly deny to give information. I have a case of around the year 2008 of Maksa Bajaj Goa. Mr. Ayyar Chodankan asked for certain details of conservation of different properties within the jurisdiction of Kalangut Village Panchayat. He arose and rejected the appeal. After complaining to Chief Information Commissioner, he arose and wrote a letter that documents requested not available and files not receivable. I could still do give judgment, but Chief Information Commissioner has already awarded the compensation. Though many laws are implemented to protect whistleblowers, many ITI activists are still held and sometimes killed. ITI is still in its infancy, and there is a need to build awareness on this. The young generation should get more involved in the working of the government, not just by joining politics, but by raising issues and making use of power such as ITI and whistleblower policy.
Thank you, Shaiti. Also, once again, thank all our speakers for giving their valuable insight on this topic. And I'd like to invite Advocate Satish Sona, lawyer, social activist, and the observer for this session, to share a few words.
Good afternoon, everybody. Well, I'm an RTI activist and sort of RTI activist. And nobody likes an RTI activist, frankly. There are so many cases are increasing where RTI activists are being murdered. The legs are being broken. Even I guess you are not going to like me when you hear what I am going to speak. The topic here today was I am going to precisely exercise my right to information right. And I am going to do it vis-a-vis the youth. I am not going to file some applications. I am just going to ask you some questions to your heart. The topic had an emphasis on the youth. And some of the speakers rightly or wrongly said that youth are partners in democracy. They are the partners. What kind of partners are you? Sleeping partners? Do you think this RTI is a your gift? Look, this RTI law was given to the nation by my generation. The generation of 50 plus. Take Arunda Roy, take Anna Hazare, whoever that matter, with the solitary exception perhaps of Arvind Kejriwal. Those were the people who agitated. Even if you want to give credit to H.D. Shauri, somebody again who has his one leg in the grave. What did the young generation do? My next question, I mean, this is something that you have to ponder. You are the student, we as society, we spend thousands and lakhs of rupees on your education. What you have done for the RTI in India? It was a gift of the senior generation. A senior generation, our still senior generation, they fought for freedom of India. And we as the next senior most generation, we fought for the second freedom of India, that is the RTI. Are the youth going to do something? Are you at least aware that rules are wrong, that in that second year commerce in Goa, that RTI, in that RTI syllabus, there was practical training of RTI and they are going to scrap it? Has a single voice been raised from the student community or the youth community? Here somebody has the cheek to say that no, why just play the roles as students union? We have to be the active citizens and the present or future political leaders of India. And forget being political leaders and big citizenship. Are you at least effective as a students union? Has a single representative of the student movement in Goa ever demanded that don't scrap those practicals from second year commerce? Why are we silent? What are we scared of? This RTI is a law. I remember Rabindranath Tagore who said, I mean, he would like to awaken a country where the mind is without fear. The head is held high in a country where the mind is without fear. Are you scared of something? Are you afraid of something? Are you afraid of telling the government that no, we want this syllabus? Don't think intellectuals like you, present or future intellectuals like you, they gifted RTI to the country. You know whom you should thank for the RTI? Do you know it? Don't take name of H.D. Shauri's and all. It was a result of a big agitation. And who did the agitation? The agitation was done by laborers. Arunda Roy might have been instrumental. She was the highest officer. These were the laborers who were working on the dam sites or road sites in Rajasthan. They were supposed to get certain wages and salaries they were not getting. And they were wondering where our monies are going, who is eating our monies. And then came the slogan, Hamara Paisa, Hamara Hisab. If it is our money, we have a right to know who is spending our monies. And it is from these laborers came up the RTI Act, are we not going to take the torch for them? They said, talks lead nowhere. The aim of philosophers has been to interpret the world. I am not a philosopher, I am an activist. Our purpose is to change the world, but I am helpless. My generation is helpless. We need your support. We need to stand on your shoulders. You have to fight to safeguard that RTI. The outcome of this, whatever that I am observing here, has to be that you will do something about it. Otherwise, I am wasting my time here. I am wasting your time here. You are wasting my time here. See, like I said, I am going to ask you some questions. Imagine there is a great dark, it's a night, and nobody can see properly anything. You are there and there are some beautiful girls around, and you are winking at a girl in the dark. Can there be any result? Will the girls be able to see it? Or the other way around, that the girls are winking at you, that also I mentioned in the presentation. Will you all be able to see? See, living life without RTI is like this. You are winking at a girl in the dark. You know what you are doing, and she does not know what you are doing. If you don't ask questions to the government will not know what is there in your heart. It is not enough that you vote. When you vote, you are so scarecrows that you don't disclose who is voting whom, because you are scared somebody will find out that yes, I have voted this party, they might take a revenge against me. But when you go with the RTI application, you need to have guts. You say, yes, I am Mr. Satish Swarang and I am asking this question. The government knows, yes, this is a person, this is a genuine person, he is not just a political crook who is asking the question. And these are the questions which are there. Like the great Vivekananda had said, he said two things. He said, tell me what songs are there on the lips of the youth, and tell me what questions are there in the hearts of the youth, and I will tell you the future of the nation. It is for our government to guess also what are the questions which are there in the hearts of the youth. I think the RTI is a great weapon that can be useful by this present generation and the generation next. But then I am not blaming you entirely. See, my generation is also to be blamed because we have brought you up in a conspiracy of a silence. Ours has been a generation, when you are kids, we teach you to talk very nicely. When you are a very small child, and the moment you start talking and yapping, you say, keep quiet, we will not allow you to talk. We have specialized, my generation has specialized in a conspiracy of silence, and so we don't like to encourage you to ask questions. Our attitude is, anante devileta isaji rahave jipti asudhave samadhana. Why allow the kids to ask questions? Why allow the young generations to ask questions? Today, if your professors, if your teachers were sitting over there in the universities, boards, and they want to scrap this RTI from the syllabus, if they want to scrap the practical component of it, some theory they will take, they are precisely doing this. They don't want you to ask questions. Because if you start asking questions, you will know that most of them from your senior generations, yes, some of them, they did their jobs. They were the practical activists. We have Prakash Kamat here. Like somebody over here said that, yes, before 2005 also the RTI Act was there in Goa, way back in 1997. Prakash Kamat was here, he led the agitation on behalf of Goa Union of Journalists. And in Goa we have that act since 1997. But where did this dress go? Most of the others, they were sleeping at that time also. And the majority today is that kind of a thing. And we are afflicted. If we allow you to ask questions, you will know what were our antecedents also. How useless our generation was also. How we have citizens of the country. Therefore, perhaps we don't allow you to ask the questions. So please, for your future, see to it. See, they say that some statistics were taken and an opinion poll and survey was taken. They say India is a country where the third best laws on RTI exist in the world. So we have the third best laws. But what is the use of having those laws if you are not going to do it? Frankly, how many of you have read the Constitution of India? Doesn't matter, it is a big document. But the RTI is a small document. That law, at least if that is not taught, where are you going to be? That is a question that I am going to ask. So please, whenever, if you want to participate really something, not just by way of the theory and wasting time, not for just getting prizes, please do something about, ask your teachers, ask the government why it is not being introduced, ask the university authorities what is not being introduced. I will briefly run over some of the points said by the speakers because my time is also up and I would not like to take. Yeah, there was Elton Fernandez, I guess, nicely reminded of Mahatma Gandhi, that instance where the questions were asked. Go a step further. What about Subhash Babu, Subhash Chandra Bose? Another big hero. Why is nobody answering and they are saying that, no, we don't want to disclose under what circumstances Subhash Chandra Babu died? Nobody wants to disclose. What are these limitations on RTI? Do we really have a democracy? This is something, if you really believe in a participatory democracy, because Subhash Babu is yet another doyen of the Indian freedom struggle. You should be the man who said, give me blood and I will give you freedom. And we don't have the courtesy to ask whether his claim really what happened to him. Yes, something was said about the ration cards by you, I think, written. Fantastic thing, he found out about the ration card, but what is really happening over there? I'm not saying this in a lighter way, perhaps in a lighter way maybe, but it appears there was a question asked under RTI, not in a ration card shop, but somewhere else, somebody who gives licenses and all that, that if a plan has to be sanctioned for housing construction, how much price should be given? An answer was given under RTI, that so and so. So the next question that is asked is, but if you want occupancy certificate, how much? And believe me, an answer was given the same uniform rates. We don't have different rates. Bribe rates are common. So this kind of things can also happen. And believe me, this is India. This kind of things. So when you say that it is a weapon for eradication of corruption, again, yes, it is a weapon for eradication of corruption if you do something about it. Once you know the information and you do something about it, otherwise you know something, you know in a broad daylight somebody is trying to rape you. The Nirbhaya is lying on the road and you are not putting some blanket on her. If you are that type of citizens, then whatever information that we are going to get, nothing is going to help. Yes, you have a right to vote, right to elect an office. But to make that logically effective, they gave you a lot of assurances, whether it was Modi or whether it was Rahul Gandhi. They promised you the moon, they promised you the sky and they got elected. Today what you need is what Anna Hazare demanded, the right to reject. That is the logical outcome of right to information. Right to vote is useless unless you don't have a right to put a vote and drive away those people, those who are not fulfilling their assurances. Merely having information will simply burden your brain. That will not be any use. That is it. When you say that you are partners, I ask you whether you are sleeping partners. Are you just going to sleep over the information which you are going to get to RTI? Be honest to your heart and ask, what you have you asked questions which are of really public importance and what you have done with that information? Pranab Kakorkar, I think, made a nice distinction between government and governance. He said about that students participating on that. Good, but like as I said, forget that politics, but at least today please try to preserve that education in your thing. Then there was Ramanand Gaukar who reminded of this Rahul Gandhi and those promises were there. Now the time has come for you to ask, whether to Rahul Gandhi or to Modi, what happened to those promises which you gave? What happened to those Akshay Din which you promised? Have those come true? And this you can ask the small questions under RTI. Unless you do it, nothing. Then there was in part 2, I think, Rina Sharma. Good. Like she gave an example of the gossiping part of it, and she said, instead of gossiping, why don't we ask the questions? That was a very interesting thing, that why don't we ask to the government? We may not know all the right answers, but yes, if we ask something, we will reach somewhere. And who was it? I think Shirin Sheikh, you said that many applications are filed by senior citizens. Maybe some people say that maybe because they have a lot of time to do it and all. What happens? What happens to the youth? Look, the statistics are a shame and a slap in your face. More citizens, senior citizens are filing RTI applications than the youth. Why does this happen? You all are too busy. Busy doing what? SMS and WhatsApp? See, there are some states where you can file RTI applications on SMS and phone. Why not fight that we should have that kind of a thing in Goa? At least let us do that. If you are a techno-savvy generation and if you love your mobile phone so much, I also love it. I am not blaming you. But yes, that can be done. And I don't have much time, so I just like one more. Swaminathan Fernandes, I think. Yeah, you said that RTI can shake the mighty. I wish it was true. Because you know what has been our experience? I mean, since you are talking of the democracies and the elections, during elections, these politicians come. The only shaking that you see is first they shake your hands. And once they are elected, they shake your confidence. The role of RTI begins there. Once your confidence starts shaking, that is the time you have to first shake yourself. You know, out of your inertia, out of your laziness, out of your who cares for the nation attitude. And you have to first feel that, yes, I belong to the nation. So it is good to ask RTI to the government. But first, please, please, please begin by asking to the question, your own heart, do you really feel you are a citizen of this country? Do you really feel this country belongs to you and you belong to this country? Do that, and the present and the future will be yours. Thank you for giving this award.
Thank you so much.
I'm
introduced by saying that we have heard both sides of this topic that is given. We have heard about what our youth can do and what we are doing. And since most of us are part of the youth, the young generation now, then we can definitely try and do something about it. Anyway, due to the constraint of time, we'll only be taking two comments from the audiences, only students, preferably someone from GBM College.
Good morning to you all. I'm not speech. थोडी भयण उलयता आणि आम्ही थंय फक्त वॉट्सॅपाचेर आसा. इट्स नॉट द वे सगळीं सरान सांगला तुमकां. बट आय वूड रिक्वेस्ट इज दॅट की एक सब्जेक्ट मांडिल्लो सरान रिगार्डींग सिलेबस टू द स्टुडंट्स. वी हॅव टू फायट बॅक. आम्ही भरपूर फायट बॅक करता आरटीआय फोरम म्हणून. पण आमच्या सरांची स्टुडंट्स रायज अप वूड रिक्वेस्ट की एक रेकमेंडेशन आम्ही गव्हर्नमेंटाक हाडपाचो विचार करता. फ्रॉम थ्रू यू ऑल स्टुडंट्सांनी एक सिग्नेचर जर कॅम्पेन आमी जर केली तर व्हेरी बेटर थिंग्स आय थिंक सो. आणि जर ॲड करपाचे हेच्या व्यतिरिक्त स्टुडंट्सांच्या सिलेबसान किती किती असपास जाय आरटीआय कळ असलं भरपूर भुग्यां. सो इट इज माय ऑनेस्ट रिक्वेस्ट. थँक्यू.
Shortly, you can post them there and be in touch with that.